Welcome, everyone. I want to thank everyone for taking the time out of your busy schedules to hang out today. I know that everyone is really busy either preparing for school, and I know some of you have already started, so I hope that your beginnings have been going well. I first want to introduce myself and the foundation. My name is Amy Heemsoth, and I'm the Director of Education for the Khaled bin Sultan Living Oceans Foundation. The foundation is a nonprofit organization located near Annapolis, Maryland, and we are dedicated to preserving, protecting, and restoring the world's oceans through science, education, and communication. So during today's Google Hangout, we are going to discover all the wonderful resources that we have available on our education portal. And we are going to also learn how to navigate this online system. Our education portal hosts our Coral Reef Ecology Curriculum, and I'll showcase some of that throughout the Google Hangout. We use coral reefs as an example to teach about everyday science topics such as meiosis, density, and other topics like symbiosis. However, that's not where this hangout ends today. We really want you to participate, and we need that participation from our virtual audience. So I want to make sure that everybody who's watching knows how to ask questions. First off, if you're going to participate in the Q&A, you need to be signed into your Google Plus account. Then if you look at the right-hand top corner of your video, you'll see that there's an oval gray button that has the letters Q and A written on it. And this should be right next to your yellow live button. Push this button. Then once you do, you're able to type in questions into the right-hand side panel. So you can go ahead and post these questions at any point during the Google Hangout, and we'll be answering as many of those questions as possible closer to the end of the Hangout. You can also vote for questions being asked. So this is called plus one-ing a question. So if you plus one a question that's being asked, we may be more likely to answer that question later because it's probably very popular. Now I think is a really good time to test the Q&A, so anybody who wants to test this out, we would love if you wouldn't mind sharing some information about yourself. First off, I'd like to know, are you a formal or a non-formal educator? What subjects do you teach, and what grade level do you teach? So while you're typing in your answers, I'm going to go ahead and get our screen ready and do a screen share with you so that you can watch us go through the website. Okay, so everybody should now see the screen share, which is our homepage of our website. And you can see this page, or view this page at www.lof.org. And in order to get to our education portal, you are going to come to the education tab here, and then you're just going to slide your mouse down to education portal and click. And this will bring you to our education portal. Again, this is where all of our coral reef ecology curriculum is being hosted. So if we just kind of scroll to the middle of the page here, you can see that there are three different users. There are students, teachers, and guests. And with these three different user types, you get access to different things. So for the students, they get quizzes. They will get all the graphics, the videos, the photos, student worksheets, and interactives. For teachers, they'll receive all of that information plus lesson plans and teacher's note pages. And then if you are a guest user, maybe you're not a teacher or you're a student, but you still like to access the information, you can still have access to quizzes, graphics, photos, videos, and the student worksheets as well. So if you want to register, I'm guessing most people are teachers in the audience today. If you want to hit the click Get Started Now red button, that'll take you down to the bottom of the page where you can create an account. So you'll fill in your information and then select what account type you are. So for instance, everyone in the audience probably today will be selecting teacher, and then there will be some more information that we ask you so that we can basically monitor who's using our website for what purposes and what grade levels. However, if you're a student, I just want to point out that we also have a functionality in here for COPA. So if you're under the age of 13, then an email will be generated to the parents to accept whether or not the student can actually participate on the website. So that's a great function. All right, I'm going to go ahead and log in as a user right now. And I'm logging in as a teacher. And so once you log in, it will take you to what is known as the dashboard. And from this place, you can actually navigate to all the different, what we call units. A unit consists of several different components, which I'm going to talk and walk you through here in just a moment. But for instance, you can see we have ecology, classification, coral anatomy, coral feeding, coral reproduction, life cycle, distribution, environmental conditions, coral growth, reef types, and reef zonation. Right now, we're going to go to the coral anatomy section. So if you click here, this will take you to the online unit. And usually one of the first things that you see will be a video. And these videos are about 2 to 5 minutes. They contain little snippets of information that the students will be learning throughout the unit. And it's a nice teaser for students to become interested in the topic. So I'm not going to play the video, but if you continue to scroll down a little bit, you'll notice that this is the actual background information. This is the meat of the unit, talking about all the information that the students need to learn to understand and comprehend what's going on. The other great thing that we have incorporated in this background information are fun facts. So if you click these little purple octopi, like this one, it'll pop up a fun fact about something that relates to the current unit. This one's really fun about the box jellyfish and how powerful its sting is. This information isn't necessary to understand the unit, but it hopefully engages the students a little bit and keeps them interested in the topic area. You can also see throughout that we have links to other places that may be relevant for the student to look at as they're going through the information. We have gorgeous photos throughout. And if we come down to the bottom of the page here, we have what we call a coral anatomy interactive. And this is an interactive way to look at a topic that might be a little obscure for students to understand. So let's go ahead and hit the play button. And this is just going to load for a moment, and then you'll be taken right to the coral anatomy unit. If you click on this Learn Anatomy section, you'll be able to look at the different parts of a coral polyp. So for instance, you can click here on the basal plate. It'll highlight where the basal plate is, and it'll also provide a definition. You can also go to different parts of this, and there are other things like videos that are embedded. Just click around. You can also click on the actual coral polyp itself and highlight an area, and it will highlight the word to the right. Here's one where you can click and see the nutrients being shared between these little coral polyps. Or you can see an animation. So here we come, and this shows how corals can feed. So I'm going to go ahead and click out of this now. Hopefully you'll come back and explore that more later. If we scroll to the bottom of the page, you'll see that there's a next section button, and this will take you to the next section of the background information. This information can also be found by scrolling up to the very top of the page and clicking on the individual sections here. We're now going to go to the next section. This one also happens to have a video associated with it. Typically, we have 1 to 2 videos per unit. We continue to scroll down a little bit. You probably have noticed that we have these blue words that are in bold here. And if you hover over the words, these are what we consider keywords that the students may or may not know, but they need to understand a unit. So if you click on one of those words, that will take you directly to our vocabulary tab, and it will also bring up that individual word. when you're looking at a definition, we have the pronunciation listed here, and then we also have an audio pronunciation. Some scientific words are extremely difficult to pronounce, so this is a nice function of the website. So I'll just play this now.
Mess. Mess.
Perfect. You can also search for a vocabulary word. So let's say we just heard about the word polyp in our Unit 3 Coral Anatomy. And so I want to search and find out, what does that word polyp mean? So I type in polyp and it brings me again back to the definition. Again, a very nice feature if you're searching for these terms. Another way to search is to just search words by the first letter of the alphabet, the letters of the alphabet. So if you want to click through any of these letters, you can see our entire vocabulary list within. All right, so we're going to go back really quickly to the end of that coral anatomy unit. Just by clicking the back button, that will take us there. And you'll notice at the end, there's a big red button that says review quiz. You can also take a quiz. So first, let's go to the review quiz button. This is a quiz that has already been taken. And once you've reviewed a quiz, you can see what you've gotten right and what you've gotten wrong by scrolling over these circles at the top. The blue means you got it correct, and the red means that you did not get it correct. So you can scroll down and see what the actual true answers were. In this case, they didn't put the answers in the correct order of the diagram. Or for instance, this one here is the same. It's just not in the same order. All right, so let's get back to my dashboard. This is a place that you can access, again, all of the different units. And I just want to take you through a couple of questions within a quiz. So let's go ahead and see if we can finish this quiz here. So you notice that there are different question types. This is a true and false question. So students can answer these questions by clicking on the various buttons. I'm not taking the time to find out if these are correct or not. And then they can hit the submit button. I believe that'll take us right to the end. So unfortunately, we didn't get any of them right. And if you get below a 60%, then you can retake the quiz. So let's just take the retake the quiz button here. And you can see this is a different type of question. It's a drag and drop, so you can put them in the different orders that they're requesting. Again, true and false. So I'm just gonna skip that one since we looked at that type already. Again, here's a diagram where you have to match the different terms to the correct letter in the diagram. It's a great function. That there and there. Great. And then there's a couple of other types that we have that are not being highlighted here, but we also have multiple choice and I believe matching. This is a matching one right here, so you can just pop them in there according to what the definition matches the word. Perfect. All right, so I'm going to go back to my dashboard again. And the next thing that we're going to look at is the For Teachers page. And this is really important for everybody here in our audience. So if you click on the For Teachers tab in the left-hand side panel, this will open up to several sub-tabs. And the first one that I really want to take a look at are the course resources. Because not only do we have these fantastic videos and background information and interactives, but we have worksheets that go along with them. So we were just looking at the coral anatomy section on the website. And so we are going to click this and see what kind of resources we have here. The first resource that will be listed and under any one of these unit tabs will be a complete teacher unit. That means anything that you would find within that unit will be combined into one overall PDF. Or if maybe you just want a couple of different worksheets, you can go and pick which ones you would like and download those rather than downloading the entire sheet. I've already got one downloaded for you here. This is the Coral Anatomy unit. You can see it looks very much like the online unit. As we scroll down, you can see that you start with a guiding page, and this is really how can you use the entire unit while you're teaching. Again, this this course can actually be used as an entire course, or it can be used individually. So again, you can pick and choose what you want to use out of the various units. You'll also notice that we also have a background section in the PDF that you can distribute to your students. And then the first worksheet that we have is usually a what we call a watch it worksheet. And these worksheets correlate to the videos that are online. So it's a great way to either maybe do a flipped classroom where you ask the students to watch the video and write down their answers before they come into the classroom so they have some understanding of it. Or maybe you're using this as bell work or something along those lines. You can see here that this students are all, or the teachers are also getting the answer key. And then we come to the different lessons. And so the lessons can vary per unit. This one happens to have three different lessons. So I'm just going to scroll really quickly to the end because there's another worksheet type that I would like to show you. There's a nice little crossword puzzle. And our worksheets are really set up in a very standard form, like most worksheets. Oops. Getting a bit of a pause there. Patient with me. All right, great. So our other worksheet type here is called a read it. So we have these logs from our, what we call the Global Reef Expedition, which is around the world mission looking at coral reefs. And we've been doing that for 5 years, and we have a very large log of various blogs. And so we want to use those blogs to teach students how to read and write, how to come up with critical thinking skills. And rather than students just diving into critical, more difficult scientific journals, this is a really nice segue to get students to read about science. So you can see here, these are mostly standardized, but they're tailored to the individual blogs. And again, these are within each unit. Great, so I'm just gonna go back to the website. And the next thing that I would like to show you is how you can search for various resources. So say that you are looking for a particular standard that you want to go over in your classroom. Then you can search by standard, and you've probably noticed already that we have our standards aligned to three different sets. We have the Next Generation Science Standards, we have the Ocean Literacy Principles, and we also have the Common Core State Standards here. So you can search by any of those various standards, and it will populate which resources hit that particular standard. You can also search here by standard or by keyword. So that's really nice, a very nice feature. The next thing that I want to look at in the For Teachers section is the My Classes. So let's click on that button there. You notice that we already have Mr. Ray's class set up for you already. And so you can set up classes as well by creating a class. You can type in what the title of your class is. Oh, if I could type today. And once you create a class, then a class code will be generated, and that is what you see here. You can give that class code out to your students and they can go in and register, and then they will be linked to you. So once they take a quiz, you'll get notification of what their quiz score was, how many times they took the quiz, and then you'll be able to download that information. So let me get back here to my other class. You see we have two classes now. This one has six registered students, as you can see. We use the characters from Finding Nemo. You can click on those individual students if you just want to get a quick snapshot of what they've accomplished. So if they were taking the, if they were going through the ecology unit, it looks like they got a 0 on their first attempt, and their second attempt they got a 59%. Or if you look at their coral feeding unit, their first attempt, they got a 97%. Let me just go back. And then if maybe you didn't want to see what an individual student got, but you wanted to look at your entire class, you could download a class scores sheet. Whoops. And I've already got that pulled up here. So if I were to download that sheet, which just takes a moment, you could see that for each unit, you could see what quizzes your students have taken and what scores they've gotten. Another really nice feature of the education portal. Oops. Oh, it looks like we can't see that sheet. I am really sorry. Hold on, let me just stop screen sharing for a moment. Okay, I'm sorry about that, folks. Let me go ahead and screen share that again. Okay, there we go. Now we can see that there is a nice Excel spreadsheet there listing the scores per unit, per attempt, and what the scores of each student were. Great. Perfect. All right, so let's go back to the teachers section. One thing I forgot to mention was in the other resources. So let's just click on that tab really quickly. And if you open up these tabs, you'll notice there's a variety of different lesson plans or videos attached to it. And these are lessons or videos or links that may, they're part of our curriculum. However, we do not have the entire unit completed yet, but we wanted to still be able to share these resources with you. So that's where you'll find them. They're in the other resources section. We also have several outside resources that we would like to share with you, and those will be hosted under the outside resources tab. Great. Next tab I would like to go to is the For Students worksheet. So if you just click on that tab in the left-hand sidebar there, you'll see that all of the different student units pop up, same as what the teachers are. And if you expand one of those bars there, you'll see that, again, there's different information here for them. So if they wanted to look at the background information, maybe in paper form rather than the website, they can download that and print it, or any of their other student worksheets. So this is really fantastic, especially if you're teaching a virtual class. You can literally just send the students to this link here and they'll be able to download the worksheet themselves. Great. So the next thing that I'd like to go back to just briefly, is the My Profile page. We haven't really seen this page, but this is how we signed up for our account. And if you want to change any information, maybe you're teaching a different class now or a different subject, or maybe you want to upload a picture. By the way, the pictures are not able to be seen by anybody but you. Then you can do that and change that information here. Next, let's just briefly go back to the dashboard. Again, this is kind of the home of where you can take quizzes, review your quizzes, or go to various units. But I wanted to point one thing out. So if you scroll down a little bit, you'll see that there's a See All Achievements. I'm going to click on that button really quickly. And so this may look familiar to many of you, Food Web. And so as students complete units and successfully pass their quizzes, they gain these badges. And if you hover over a badge, it tells you, that you successfully completed the unit and that you just acquired the sea cucumber badge. And it tells you exactly what purpose sea cucumbers have in the Food Web. So again, another really nice little teaching tool built in to that dashboard. Fantastic. All right, so this is really the conclusion of the tour of the website and the different various educational materials that we have to offer. However, I do want to point out that if you do need more information or need to understand how to use a particular resource, you can go back up here to the For Teachers section, and you can come down here to how to use our curriculum. And that information will all be found under these two tabs here. Additionally, if you're having any any problems or you need more information, please feel free to send us an email by clicking on this orange button down here at the bottom of the page.